My name is Joel. I'm the producing artistic director at Firehouse. Got a couple of announcements before we start the show. Please turn off your cell phone. If you need to leave before intermission, which will be about a little less than an hour into the show, I think, please walk up the center aisle, and there's an exit out of the audience area in the back there. And then if you're going to the bathrooms and you don't know where they are yet, they're all the way down towards the bar and then up a very steep flight of steps. So watch your way going up and coming down. There are two fire exits in the building. The door you came in, there's an exit sign over by the bar that leads to a door that will take you out to the back courtyard. I think that's all the sort of logistical stuff you need to know. How many of you have never been to Firehouse before? Welcome. I hope you'll come back. As you may know, maybe you can come back tonight and see the show again. There's a 7:30 performance of Carrying the Load. And so this is our 22nd season here. It's a converted fire station. And we're calling this season a season of radical change. And we're calling it that because we're doing things a little differently than how Firehouse used to operate or how most theaters operate. So we're expanding the definition of what theater means to include performance of all kinds. So besides doing co-productions like this performance of Carrying the Load, which are sort of short runs and community partnerships, we do our own productions. But then we have a series that we call the Fringe Series. And in that series, we do music, we do poetry, we do cabaret, we do burlesque, we do magic, we do storytelling. A range of different programs. The best way to figure out what's going on here, because we're doing about 200 things a year, is to go onto our website, which is firehousetheater.org, or like us on our Facebook page. And there are a few of these cards left outside. I got to print some more next week of everything that's coming up in our Fringe series in March and April. And I highlighted a few of the things, but there are more listed here. So the show's about an hour and 20 minutes long. There is an intermission. Thank you very much for coming. I'll be around after the show if anybody has any questions about Firehouse. Thank you very much for coming.
I'm trying to lower that boy. boy yours. I'm gonna be mighty mad if you load that boy. Might be better if there was some white outside calling us out compared to the way Papa be if you find your dog tomorrow like you grow.
Well, I've got 18-year-old, getting old, too old to be married, old enough to be eloped.
Papa don't care how old you think your ears clear, he worried about you being married. Especially man and poor dirt from me.
Well, everybody can't be like Papa written land and men's and women's is meant to be married. The Bible say that man is supposed to leave their father and mother and be united as one flesh.
Now what the Bible say, but what Papa say? Besides, your whole family is poor and hard. Your life is gonna be the same.
I think I hit something. Maybe not. Anyway, Papa know that Elijah been coming over here for a year now. Ain't no other callers.
Well, you ain't got no line of boats. So your mind set on marrying Elijah even though Papa don't even like him?
Yeah. It's like they're meant to be together or something.
Well, I don't know. They're both strange. He legitimately like. Every Sunday after meeting in that same blue suit and tie with no hat. Just before 6, we're always going by 9. Not even 9:05.
Why? He has to go to field Monday morning now.
He is important enough to visit, but not too long.
Well, it's long enough for me, and that's all that matters. You know, Elijah's there. He said, Clara, when I be walking that old rock road, you know that road outside our house? He said, that road be hard and hot and dusty and a bit long. At the end is my gal, Clarabelle. That's what he say to me.
Them press cars walk over here to get you.
How gonna get married, Clarabelle? What you even gonna wear? Why I be wearing this here dress? It's nice and clean and kind of fancy. Plus, I got matching gloves.
You and your gloves.
Well, a woman needs gloves to cover her hands from being rough out there and planting the flowers. Elijah said, he said, your hand's softer than a newborn chick. That's fine, he is real fine.
He sure said a lot.
This is how the land
is. That asthma voice of his. He take you off in the night and nobody know where you are, then what the message be then? You might hit not riding snakes or just playing me for
post. Stop busting, Rose. The Lord will provide. My mind is set on this call.
Well, if you just got to leave in the middle of the night, at least look decent. Let me do your hair.
Thank you, Rose, but you gotta be quick at it. Elijah should be back soon, and I need to be ready. Sure wish I had a church wedding, but Elijah said he talked to the reverend all settled for tonight.
He Baptist, you're Pentecostal. When y'all decide to do all this? Sunday? Ain't none of this romantic life.
We settled for sure earlier when Elijah stopped by. He time wait for Papa's permission. He said that he'd be back soon when everybody's asleep to collect me and to pack a bag and be ready.
He sang you a song. Gave the flowers a kiss or something. Oh, Clarabelle, I mean, your bold talk soft, but I don't think he really gentle.
He gentle with me? Besides, what do you gotta be gentle with no world like this for anyway? Man, you'd be a little hard to survive.
No, I don't know, Clara. I mean, your beau Elijah, he will. Something about him sad or maybe mad.
He both. You know, when Elijah was just a boy, he got lost in the woods. His papa didn't let him go in those woods. He avoids if he went anywhere. Well, he saw something that no boy's supposed to see. He saw a man being lynched by 3 wise men.
For real?
Yes. And here he is, just a boy. That ain't nothing for no boy to see or to be worried about. And after that, poor Elijah Trump will soon want things right for colors.
I don't know how you can go up here in 1917 Georgia and not see a lynching, burning, beating, even if there is a child.
Well, see, that's the thing. See, Elijah saw his friend being killed. His papa left him from there, but you can't remove that man from being his heart bleeding from there.
Remember, Clara, girl, when man's be a lot like a white man, we
but you're too dark to talk dissatisfied.
He high yellow and pretty to me.
You're shiny, you're bright as night, and he's shining right next to you.
The night is like God's love all around us.
Elijah and Clara, the star and crescent. Oh, you was better to be married, Clarabelle. Where am I gonna live after you elope? Papa ain't gonna let your or your new husband come back here.
Well, I don't know. We might move in with Elijah's brother. Sam, he always makes me feel right welcome.
Will the Lord provide some Pompeii for your hair? Give me some of that for damn CJ Walker gloss sleeve. They're as rough as a washboard. Well, at least you're getting married in March, Clarabelle, when it ain't so hot.
Just make it look nice, Rose. Elijah already think I'm pretty.
There you are now, Mrs. Poole. That show sounds nice.
I like that much better than Clarabelle or Quarter Evans' daughter or Mary Lou or Quarter Evans' daughter or one of them girls or what the wife's yelling, you that girl, child? Yes, Mrs. Poole sounds like a real Mary thing. What's that sound? That Elijah back! Well, I guess I got everything. Don't have much but this old bag that holds everything I know and only this here living. I know Mama gonna be happy and tell her all right. I know Papa gonna be better. Tell her the Lord sent Elijah to me.
Well, I'm scared for you. Nobody know where you be at some night riders catch you. Your man being so poor and...
Shh. Listen. All right. The Bible says that there is no fear in love. Perfect love casts out fear. I ain't afraid, and don't you be lying, bro. I'm getting married today, March 17th, 1917.
Goodbye, Clarabelle Evans. Oh, Lord, help her and keep her safe.
Stop by Elijah and Claire. Let's stop and get a tape.
Take no money for that. This be a depression in Dry County. We all thought there'd be work up here in Detroit, but that's wrong.
This place ain't no better than Jordan. Not for us. Elijah, Claire, not for anybody.
No, Jordan, it's better than that. Remember Elijah had that threat on his life in Macon? And he ain't want no more Georgia after that there Glover business.
How can I forget that? I can't forget. Glover chased down by a mob of 500 white folks. They hunted him like a dog, lynched him up, shot him over 100 times, even after they know he dead. They set on fire and burned that man.
He ain't got me. That's how they took his bloody clothes and used his souvenirs. What kind of man buy murder man clothes? What kind of man sell it?
A white man from Georgia. I literally bought the police in Sunday service and messed up our service. That time they burned down all them lodges and they burned seven churches. And then it was that time they beat that 72-year-old man down just for defending that black woman that was raped by them white boys. And then it was that
time...
Got
enough, Jarman. Them no type of things to remember.
Huh, I do remember when Elijah left Georgia. He said he done seen enough of the white man's viciousness to last in 26,000 years. Now I wonder, is 26,000 years enough time to forget the hard life of a colored man in 1920s Georgia?
Oh no, John. I just don't know.
Yeah. Oh, girl, I can leave if it be time for family business talk. But why I came over. I can't pick my check up until 10. So you got some flour or some beans to spare? I can't use them sour ones though.
You like family. Mm.
Know my son Manny?
Yeah.
He go root in the weeding fields and yards all around the town. Sometimes, friend, he give me good real dandelion rings to carry over to the next paycheck. Manny, go tell Mother Marie she get a meal real soon, Manny. And come back and get that rock dirt off you.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, friend, your mother-in-law shouldn't mix your boy child in the family business. It seems like your son busy taking care of you. What's your husband do?
Life is hard for Elijah. He done got laid off from Detroit Copper, Rig's Body, Chevrolet Axle. Hard for him to find a job in depression, even up here north.
Well, the north is not the promised land. I mean, it ain't no paradise here in Detroit either. With the race riots, the unemployment, and the Klan. But girl, even with all of that, it is still better than the south.
You know, I don't know. See, it seems the same to me. Dirty homes, trashy streets, bad schools. It's almost like they want to keep us in the gutter.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of the gutter, that's what I came over here to tell you. I saw your man.
What you mean you saw Elijah?
Oh, now, Clara, when was the last time your husband been home this week?
Now, don't start talking none on Elijah. See, Elijah always go when it's time for me to stand down there that sister's side, and then go on again when he at the end and have nothing left. Haynes, Tennessee is living like this. And he too proud to see us like this, and he just always just proud. What you from? You know Elijah is a proud man.
How proud he be laying in the gutter drunk?
What you mean?
Oh, now Claire. Don't go putting on your little southern air. Everybody in the neighborhood sees your husband staggering down the street drunk. Why, it was just last week he was arrested for public drunkenness. And everybody can hear you. I know you be scared of him, so don't act like you don't know what I mean. Right now, he laying in some gutter, not 5 blocks from here, knocked out on cheap wine.
Well, I'ma go get him,
girl.
Elijah's no gutter bug. I carried his burden myself. See, it's just like shit popping. If Elijah gets tired and bleeding for the pain of this life, his load.
Now, Clara, your best bet is to let your husband's people go and fetch him.
No, look, man, no. See, what he said was, look, he said they done made the color man out to be drunk. Made like that. Hands out at the white man's table waiting for drunk to fall off. That's what he said, and that's the truth.
I heard him too drunk, remember? Hi, Sarah. Ladies, how y'all be?
Fine.
Just fine. How y'all? Oh, Sam. Look, he said slavery. It wasn't made to color man the way we be. Negro don't know that true self no more.
What y'all boys talking about? I think I done heard this kind of talk before.
I suspect many folks that have been down there to Haitian Street to hear the message from Negro.
How y'all beat y'all? Sam? Can I get y'all something?
Water fine, Claire.
Look, Sam, he said all white people. Water. What you got to eat for real, Claire?
What y'all talking about?
Yes, ma'am. The message for Negroes.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. I suspect it's a mighty fine message. What you think there, Jones?
Sure it is. It's about time. come go get that filth out there. I want to be one of them men.
Well, Johnny, you sound like you've been waiting on the men on Hastings Street your whole life.
Clara, you carrying all this stuff by yourself? Let me and John will pick up here and outside. Come on, John.
Look, colored man will be free.
Colored man gonna be free, John, if they be responsible. White man don't make it easy for us for sure. But if colored man be responsible, taking care of himself and his community, ain't no need for colored folks to be harming each other the way they do.
No, Sam. Colored man doing because that's all the white man let us do. No.
Claire, I know just what they talk about.
How you know? Where you been?
Girl, I've been down on Hastings Street. I heard the message and I like it.
He say we as colors, we ain't always been what we is.
Girl, he say we descendants from kings and queens.
Mm-hmm.
He say we lost our knowledge.
Mm-hmm. He say all that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, girl. He say we lost mouths. He say it straight from the Bible. Luke 15:32. For your brother was dead and is alive, he was lost and is found.
Now he sounds like a good Christian man.
Yes, he do. He no Christian. He say he from the east. He is Islamic. And not like the poor. You know, east like across the ocean. I don't know where that is though.
Well, what's his name? What do you do?
Well, I can't recollect his name right off, but I saw him. He was short, thin, mulatto, almost like a white man with jet black straight hair. His lecture halls be bursting at the scenes with people. Plus, guess what? They say he give you a quarter just for showing up. Well, that's wrong. I don't know.
You know what? I think I might go see this man where they be at.
Well, how you do that? It'll take a lot of time. They be at 3408 Hastings Street.
You know what? Mm-hmm. I think I might go take a lot down there. Yes. He needs to hear. Can't hurt none. Might even help.
Well,
what they be talking about?
How you gonna do that? How you gonna be alive down there?
Well, you know, all we women's got to do is tell our husbands we wants to go somewhere, and then they to tell us they need to check it out first.
Yeah, girl, men's be like that.
Mm-hmm. Well, I got to get rid of all this stuff from the crowd in our house. Go get Elijah from down there in that gutter and see what that man can talk to him about that Hastings Street. What
did
they talk about
them? Well, he mainly say it's time for Negroes in America to get back to the religion of their ancestors. He say Islam is the only religion that'll change the condition of the colored man in America. Girl, it might be true. Miss Johnson's husband went down there and he ain't drank, played the dice, or the number six.
What? Now, ain't that something?
Mm-hmm.
Must be nice to have your whole paycheck used up on what you need.
You're right about that.
Mm-hmm. It seems like Elijah barely paid before he used his paycheck on gambling, drinking, or whatever. And with 5 kids, I be needing that check. You know my son, man? Yeah. Well, he used my raggedy shoes just because we can't afford to repair his.
Drafty and dirty as that school be, that must be hard.
Real hard!
Yeah.
You know that school? That school don't teach our children nothing. Nothing that's gonna help my son be a better man.
Yeah.
Now what we need to do, we need to open up our own schools. Hmm. Teach our own children. Now W.E.B., he got the answer.
Look how rough my hands be.
I remember when I married Elijah. He love my rough, my soft.
But this whole Detroit, this Detroit done messed up my softness, my soft hands.
Well, wouldn't it be nice though?
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be nice if we were really kings and queens?
Yes, girl.
You was the queen of the mop, and I'm the queen of the wash. yeah, but queens need kings. And right now my husband is out there somewhere laid out drunk.
Sorry, Clara, ain't no disrespect. Just coming up the walkway, and her said something about Elijah. We family, you can't keep stuff like that from us. Where he be?
Sorry, Sam.
I seen him by Madison up the way.
Well, look here. I'm gonna get John, and we gonna go out and look for him. I know Elijah might have a load. Put them up on your shoulders, your own self. But don't you worry no more. We'll take care of me and Jarman. We go fetch him now.
God knows what comes next. You know, the man never did come back and tell me if that sweater fit after. Or come get some of this warm water.
But we finishes it if they attack us. Now that was sure.
Now, no need for fighting if we're peaceful. That March 27 edition of the Detroit Free Press calling us a voodooist cult. Might have started some of the fighting, but we didn't get involved with that. We just let it be.
I ready to fight. I was itching for somebody to pull out a billy club.
Yeah, for a while. We not about no foolishness from myself or those. Now, they have tried to start stuff with us. For instance, Mr. Archibald Henniger of the Detroit School Board, he put Mr. George Shudley, the chief prosecutor, on the case.
Well, that was something, though.
Sure enough, and Mr. Shudley himself, he came down to the school trying to catch us doing something, right? Trying to catch us doing something, but what? We're teaching our children. But you know what we did? We, therefore why? We stopped and told them, make an appointment. They came in there and tried to cause trouble, but they didn't start nothing with us. We was peaceful and let them be about their business.
But you remember, they was quick to bring back 8 more policemen.
Yeah, they did. But what they did find though, they were sure surprised. But they couldn't get nothing on us. They came in there, what they found us doing, we were teaching our children high knowledge. Stuff like trigonometry, physics, astronomy. But they couldn't find us doing nothing other than that. They didn't find no problem from us. You understand, John?
Well, the most important thing is to teach our children true knowledge of self.
Sure enough. Come on, John. Let's see what's happening down there at Haitian Street.
Burned alive.
Elijah and I,
Elijah and I, that's why we left the South in the first place. Mm-hmm. See, he used to be afraid of all that burning and lynching. But this here, Islam. Islam teach us about freedom, equality, and justice. Mm-hmm. He made a man out of Elijah. Yes, he does.
Well, I already say, you got a lot of big words. You even talk different. Is that what you got up here? Freedom, justice, and equality? Well, there is just as many Klan here in Detroit as there is in Georgia. Your man be hung from the nearest tree and you're right next to him.
My husband is just like Elijah in the Bible. A messenger. He brings forth the message for all of the colored man in America. We're not worried about the Klan.
Well, if you ain't, I is, Clarabelle. We've been free since the emancipation by President Abraham Lincoln himself. You know, colors ain't got no business looking for justice and equality from the whites. His job be to live in peace with white folk so they don't have to show just how unjust they can be.
Mother, please. Please calm down. Can I get you something?
Some greens with a bit of ham be right nice.
Mother, Muslims do not eat pork. We follow the rule of the Old Testament.
Yeah.
God himself said that ain't no good. And they used to feed. Actually, let me repeat myself. Whites used to feed slaves, pork, because they didn't care what we eat.
My mammy also told me that white folk ate plenty of ham and bacon during slavery time. It was good eating for slave and free Negro, too. You used to like it, Clarabelle.
I know better now, Mother. Mm-hmm. Master Wally Farr taught me that.
Okay.
Do you know that pigs eat their own, live in their own ways? What are you really eating if you are eating pork?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You a professor now or something?
No, but I've been studying. Mm-hmm. That's why I talk better than I used to.
Yeah.
We Muslims, we open up our schools. We call it University of Muslims. University of Islam, excuse me. I helped set it up. In fact, the first one started in its very own house at that very table.
I didn't hear it all now for sure.
Mother, you see my son?
Yep.
Do you see my son, Mother?
Yes.
He is 7 months.
Mm-hmm. I know how old he is.
But it won't be the same with my son. No, it won't. We will lift as we climb. My intention for all of Negro children is to help them know that they know their true self and to give them higher knowledge.
How did you get that name Wallace there for?
Well, Master Wally Farr told me and Elisha that we were going to have a boy child and that he wrote it on the pantry dump. Told us that if it ever starts to fade, then all we got to do is use chalk to write over.
What? Well, that don't make no sense to me. Using chalk, writing on walls everywhere. You Muslims got some strange ways. I mean, chalk, prophecy. Well, I just don't know.
Mother?
Assalamu alaikum, Claire. How you listen?
What's wrong?
Well,
like it's wrong. What's wrong? Is everything all right?
We need some bail money, Claire.
Bail money? Y'all got some mighty big trouble then.
There's been some trouble over there on Hastings Street. The drug board of education didn't come in. Brought 15 armed policemen and raided the school.
Again?
What you mean again? This didn't happen before.
Is everybody all right?
No, they ain't all right. There was about 13 teachers and staff in there. And this time they arrested them all. Charged them with contributing to the delinquency of mass. And this time they took two of the children. Brother David Sharif and Sister Sarah Ali.
They took little Sister Sarah Ali. Where is Elijah?
John! I told you! Don't come over here along the clearing here. I done got some bail money. I done got some bail money from the FOI. We on our way to the police station. They seen us and what they did to us. Crowd the building.
Well, I better get over there to help little sister Stella Ali. Mother, she bound to be frightened.
Ain't you frightened for your own husband? I suspect police in Detroit treat a colored man real bad if arrested.
Ain't gonna be no police brutality now, I'm telling you. Ain't nobody coming up in our temples and our school just carrying off our women and children like they some animal. Not get away with it. The police, Detroit Board of Education, whoever, they thinking wrong if they thinking that.
Gentlemen, I told you to be quiet. And I mean it.
Look, they just went berserk because they saw 400 names on the roads of the school. That's all it is. They talking about this here Muhammad got 400 children. Then they get mad because we ain't got no American flag nowheres in the building. Then they try to disown our flag. Flag of freedom, equality, and justice. Islam.
Y'all got 400 colored children you done took out of school and put in your own school?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Gentlemen, ladies, we gotta get on the do to what we got to do. Come on here.
Right about now, right uncomfortable.
Mother, nothing is going to happen to Muhammad's 400 children learning how to submit and obey to Muhammad, to Allah. Allah is God. Mm-hmm. He loves us and our babies.
Educating your own seems a mighty arrogant thing. You Muslims is out of control.
Mother, you know, the United States Congress work. We're talking about 10 years ago in the 1920s about how they didn't want to give money to Howard University right there in Washington, D.C. Some of them were, well, actually most of them were colored Christians themselves. The point I'm making is that the U.S. authorities are always talking about how the so-called Negroes are what to do or what to say, how to
read it. Hey! Slow down there, boy. You know better be running through the house like that, especially with little brother laying here arrested.
What is it, son?
There's a riot over on Aces, Mama. Everybody been arrested. Daddy, Brother Ambassador Sewell, Brother Joseph, all arrested. Even Uncle Sam and John arrested now for trying to help. They say crowd got out of control, and maybe 13 police officers are injured. They say 30 men going to jail, plus some 9 women and 4 students.
Calm down, son.
Now, listen, stand back. Now, Clara, I know something about this here thing now. I know about it. Your husband and their brothers, his people, they better get out of town quick if they're able to get out of jail before the police beat them to death.
Mother, don't scare them, son.
Who at the door?
Good morning. I'm looking for a Mrs. Clara Poole.
I am Mrs. Muhammad.
Mrs. Poole, may I speak with you a moment? You seem a woman of good sense.
No, sir, you may not. My name is Mrs. Muhammad, and my husband is not home. We do not allow unknown men such as yourself to come into our home. However, you can talk to me at the door if you please.
I'm not here to struggle with you, Mrs. Poole. I'm a representative of the Detroit Department of Education Attendance Office. Our records indicate that there are some 5 children who reside here who are not currently enrolled in state schools. Now, according to the Detroit Codes of Education, all residents under the age of 16 must attend mandatory education provided by the state. Well, that boy right there looks like he should be in school.
He is in school. We educate our own in this house. Son, please go upstairs. And sir, please remember to call me by my name, Mrs. Muhammad.
Yes, Mrs. Poole. But it is against the state codes for any persons not licensed by the state of Michigan to hold illegal instruction in their home or any other building. Now I'll have to ask you to accompany at this time.
Sir, I will not be accompanying you any day or any tomorrow or any, nowhere.
I
if the intention is to enroll my children in the so-called Negro of the Detroit public schools.
I beg your pardon?
I said no.
No, I don't understand. Here in Detroit, we take great pride in the education we provide for our Negro children. The state code clearly goes on to say that. Oh.
Sir, the state itself has no condition or no education that they should be proud of. I do not need to see your state code. However, I do have the authorization whether to determine where my children should reside to go to school. I have a higher authority than the state.
Who authorized you? Now look here, Mrs. Poole, I must warn you. Failure to comply could lead to the forcible removal of yourself and your children from this place. Your continued noncompliance could result in legal action. The police would be involved. Now, if you don't think I won't bring the police down here to take those children out, you better think again, gal.
Maybe you should cooperate. Your husband, maybe his brother, his people, they done got arrested and they said police beat women and children. Now, this here thing is serious.
Listen to good advice now, but there's gonna be trouble, you hear? The Detroit Board of Education Attendance Office has ordered that your children register for classes. Now let's get to it. You understand. You keep this up, there's liable to be trouble. Could get hurt. I know you don't want that.
Sir, do you see my plants? These plants, I grow and I cultivate them. It's just like the Negro children in the Detroit public schools. It's like planting a garden under rock. It's never going to get rid of all the ignorance or all the things that happen. Sure. You can grow a dandelion green in an oppressive weight and concrete. But imagine what happens when a cultivated garden grows. That is what happens at our schools. We grow and we cultivate the beauty and strength of our children, our Negro children.
Now I'm done tangling with you, Mrs. Ford. I could come back with the police and put that boy just so in my car and take him to school myself.
Sir, I need your mom, and I too do not want trouble.
But then stop being so stubborn. Now I'm taking these children out of here, and I'm putting them someplace where they can get a real education. You keep this up, and the police will be right here at your door. You understand me, Gavin?
Let the police come. Listen to me, and you listen to me well. I'd be dead as this door still if I enroll my children into the Detroit public school. Now, do you understand that?
Sister Clara moved to Chicago and brought this letter.
Yes, sir, Brother Captain. Why did they move here? Weren't they in Detroit?
Well, they had to leave Detroit after the threats on their lives. The rumor had gone around from Sister Clara all around Paradise Valley that police and federal men wanted Master Farrar and the messenger Elijah dead or alive.
Most likely dead.
It's all about power. See, they don't want us to have power, ourselves or our men. But we have power when it comes to our children. and we made sure that we were able to maintain that power. Yes, sir. So look here, but Lieutenant, I got a book here. This is the Time Weekly magazine right here.
Looks to be about 8 or 9 years old. Yes, it says right here, April 30th, 1934.
Yes, sir. Look here. So 1934, when it was, look in the table of contents, see it under University of Islam?
Well, I'll be. A nation of Muslims in a national weekly magazine like Time.
They tried to stop the University of Islam in Detroit, but they couldn't. Why? When the messenger and Sister Clara had arrived here in Chicago, recruiting for and filling up a school with students, well, the first thing Sister Clara did, yes it was, they had more than 400 students back in Detroit.
All praise is due to Allah. 400. I didn't know Detroit had that many Muslim kids.
The school wasn't just for Muslims, you know. I intend was to teach all the colored children high knowledge. And the Negro parents knew the condition of Detroit public schools. So they put their children in our schools, whether they was Muslim or not.
Ain't that something?
They knew, like Sister Clara Muhammad said, can't nobody teach you better than your own.
That's true. We do have our own best interests at heart.
Look here, let me read what it's saying in Time. Week by week, during recent months, Negro markets have been disappearing in batches from Detroit's public schoolrooms. One day, 10 black pupils would be reported missing, and the next, it would be 20. Meantime, reports grew that a Negro cult school called the University of Islam, near that Negro cult school, was making corresponding gains. Along, teachers complained to the city attorney. Detroit's truant officers called at the University of Islam, housed on the second floor of an old brick theater building, 10 blocks east of the city downtown business district, and had the doors shut in their face.
Brother, the police have raided temple number 1 in Detroit and closed it.
What? Walaikum salam, sister. Calm down. What do you mean?
Captain, that's the call I got. It's closing right to left. Some more of my brothers put in jail. Sisters along with their children.
Now we can't have that.
Look here. We're going to have to find out what's going on there at that school.
Never.
You got a brother in 10?
Never.
That's right. They won't be able to lock enough of us up, sister.
Captain, the messenger, 45 years old. How can he be accused of dodging the draft? Who drafted
that
at that age? And
then
he's sitting in jail for it.
You're right, sister. The devil done got into the people, and they're trying to hurt this nation of Muslims.
That's right.
Well, sister, he's been jailed for false pretense. Sir Emmanuel, not for 5 years. And that brother her daughter is engaged to, maybe Sharif, not for 2. Really going
through
something.
Well, Sister Clara is strong. And they ain't gonna be able to hold enough of us that we can't protect Sister Clara and the rest of the women. We need to find out what's going on. Go investigate.
Yes, Brother Captain.
Come on, Brother Tinny, sister.
Reminds me of the verses you have now. I can read sort of the Fatiha in English and Arabic now.
possibly could.
Son, one day soon, you're going to, we are going to teach. We're going to have an Arabic-speaking teacher for you and your brother. Come in. Pray with me.
Surely I have turned myself to trying to be upright to he who originated the heavens and the earth. I am not of the polytheist. Surely my prayer, my sacrifice, my life and death are all for Allah, Lord of all the worlds.
Excuse the intrusion, Sister Clara. Oh, I see you are reading the Quran. Always studying you are.
Yes, sir, I am. I'd like to include passages of the Holy Quran, since the prison won't allow my husband and son to have the Quran.
All praise is due to Allah. It's like the messengers say, the black woman is the key to the black man's success.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. But Sister Clara, we have urgent business. Police have raided Detroit Temple Number 1 and shut it down. We've got to fight.
Brothers, we do not need any more of our Muslim brothers locked away. If the police have raided our temples, then we can just use our homes. They cannot tell us who we cannot have in our houses now, can they?
Yes, sister, but so many sisters are left alone with the brothers jailed.
Brother Captain, why don't we have some of our single brothers donate some of their paycheck to the sisters. Let's house sisters whose husbands who've been locked away with other sisters so that it's easier to take care of and protect.
Yes, ma'am. Consider it done.
Thank you. And if the temple has been locked away by the police, then we have saved money. Tell me, how are our schools?
Well, to be truthful, sister, it's quite a burden to keep them open. And if we're going to have them open with the temples closed, then that's not going to be possible. Temples shut down, so schools shut down. We let the mothers take care of their children.
Plus, the young Muslims are so strong in their Islam, they can just go to public schools. And then once we get back on our feet, then we can reopen the schools.
There is no future if we do not nurture our own brothers. If the choice is to keep the temple going or the University of Islam going, then choose the school.
I just must disagree with you, Sister Clara. Sister Clara, I just must. I mean, now you've done a good job opening schools, but now it's too many to keep open. We've got schools everywhere, Chicago, Detroit, D.C.
Brother, what goes on at the temple?
Teaching, sister. Teaching the lost found true knowledge of self.
Have you found your true self? Are you lost? Are you lost or found?
Found. Found the truth. Found my true religion. Found my true self. Found my true nature. All praise be to Allah.
So you're saying, brother, that you would never go back out there into that dead world?
So what, ma'am? Sad niggas resigned to their fate. I got the suit on right now, but I grew up with a bib on my britches, sharecropping in Bama, where a white man was the only thing twisted backwards and ignorant. No, ma'am. Negroes trying to escape life harshness down at the juke joint, getting all licked up, busting and cussing over nonsense. To have to get up and, yes sir, boss, in the field every day, hate every minute of it. Too scared to do anything about it. Scared they lose their job. Scared boss blackball them. Scared that the sheriff pick them up for nothing. Scared that the wife will burn down the town if they don't act scared enough. I was one of them scared Negroes. Cowards. That dead world made me a coward. Too afraid to risk my life, to give myself a life. No knowledge of my history or pride of myself as a Negro. No, ma'am, that dead world, I don't want to go back to that. The nation, sister, it freed me from that. It's gone. Come.
What about you, Brother Captain?
No, madam. The teachings changed me. I hated myself. Do you hear me, sister? Hated myself. I hated myself and everything. I hated my skin, my hair, my body, my lips, everything about myself. I hated being colored. I hated being poor. I hated being ignorant. Yeah, I was ignorant. I knew I was ignorant. I used to wake up wanting to hurt somebody. Matter of fact, that ignorance brought me to want to tear something up. Pull a gun on a man while playing craps. Tear up the club and drunk. Kick children when I was cussing at them. Yeah. The teacher's changing, sister. Change. Spend all my money playing the numbers, run women, run game like some old wild animal. Islam changed me. It cleaned me up, woke me up, set me up right. Told me to love a real God. Love my family. Love my woman. Love myself. And finally, my own self I love, my own black self I love. All praise is due to Allah. No, sister, I don't want no more of that dead word.
Well, then, I am confused, brothers. Both of you talk about not wanting to put yourself back in that dead world, yet you want to put your children there.
No, ma'am.
Brothers, think about it. What kind of people would we be if we sit here as Muslims ourselves but don't make no effort for our children to be? Every nation on this planet must pass its knowledge on to its offspring. So why are we talking about doing something different?
Yes, ma'am, you're absolutely right. You spoke the truth.
Let's move the classes to different houses around the city. We can teach early in the morning or late at night, form co-ops for sisters who know and those who don't know, and have the older children teach the younger. We have got to educate our Negro children so we can be a mighty nation. Yeah. All praise is due to our Allah, brothers. All praise is due to Allah. Well, Lessa, can I get your brother some tea? It's nearly sundown now. I'll go ahead and start some in the kitchen.
That sister sure is something. I tell you, she has done right. I can't complain about the way she has run the nation since the messenger has been in prison.
That sister is running things, brother. She's running.
Yeah, she don't let nothing happen to that university. It's not nothing. All praise to Allah. To Allah.
You know, brother, she's right. The children are our future.
Yes, they are. They're not only our future, but they are our power. Just imagine, if we can teach a whole generation of black children a knowledge of self, where would we be in this world, brother?
And remember that thing that God has said, brother? That's right.
As long as we can keep the schools open, Sister Clara wouldn't want it any other way. University of Islam, be Sister Clara Muhammad schools.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We'll never go. in a little tent. Oh, and just like the river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother.
Yes, sir. That sister running the Nation of Islam. She running it. That one powerful little black woman.
She don't let nothing happen to that University of Islam, though. Nothing. They should have named it the school after her.
Maybe one day they will. The children.